Our mission is to serve the health and well-being of each individual we serve.
It's really about building healthy communities.
I'm Arpan Wagre. I'm the medical director for behavioral medicine at Swedish Health Services.
I'm Phil Kapp, the medical director of ambulatory behavioral health.
Behavioral health is caring for patients with various spectrums of illnesses, mood disorders, anxiety spectrum disorders.
The suffering is one part, but then the tremendous cost is another part of populations that have chronic medical illness and comorbid and active psychiatric disease. That group of people suffers the most and consumes the most resources across the U.S. healthcare system, and that is really the group that we're interested in addressing.
We need to take a more holistic approach. We cannot have these artificial divides between physical healthcare and mental healthcare.
We also know that services that are guided by the primary care provider tend to be more palatable for patients. This syncs up nicely with this idea that we need to move to a lower cost infrastructure for delivering care, and all of those things boil down to delivering psychiatric services on the chassis of primary care.
There is 20 years of great research that we are using to apply in our new program, which has a multi-tiered approach.
Tier one is really about embedded, brief interventional therapy in a primary care setting. Tier two is about collaborative care meetings around populations of interest and managing comorbid medical and psychiatric disease. Tier three is traditional face-to-face consultative psychiatry. And tier four is close community partnerships around the care of the severely, persistently mentally ill.
Our focus is always the patient. So if there are multiple providers involved in the care of a patient, we would like the patient to be located in one place and the doctors will take turns and other providers will take turns going around as many rooms as we have to.
One of the challenges we've had as a big system is how to flexibly appropriate resources.
We know that in chronic disease management, the cost of care for managing an illness like, say, diabetes is 2 times higher when you have a comorbidity like major depression or alcoholism. And this is true for various multiple medical conditions. And hence the model identifies natural clusters of illnesses so that we're able to drive care pathways for all these illnesses and effectively treat our patients.
Patients, when they have access to services that can heal them and they're able to take advantage of them, their lives do get better. They go back to work, they're successful, and they contribute.
We are very, very proud of what we're doing. We do believe that this is an approach that will help us serve some of our most vulnerable. And that is precisely why we are in this work.